Yeah.
So, this is the one that had Simsimaruni. Little tough for her this morning because she actually saw this young lady. I didn't know that. Her name is Geraldine Bailey. She had cancer. She wanted to see Usain Bolt. He went to see her, but unfortunately she died over the weekend. She'd been in hospital while her condition deteriorated, but had maintained a strong spirit and managed to share moments on social media site. Mm. I want to show you a picture. Sim actually went to see her. That's Usain with her there. But she had sent out a call. She says, I'm a big fan of Usain Bolt. So Usain Bolt, if you're hearing me right now, I wish I could see you in real life. And she said she was very ill. Her wish, as we said, would eventually come true when Usain went to see her. And she said she was delighted, but she was physically weak. So there's Usain.
A very strong little girl. Yeah. I mean, she was
supposed to
preach.
We're going to show you the video
like
first, and then we're going to show you the picture with... I think there's a video when she asked Usain to see her. Let's look at the video. Where's the video?
Hi, everyone. How are you?
You're not seeing anything.
I am a big fan of Usain Bolt. So if Usain Bolt, if you're hearing me right now, I wish I could see you in real life. I'm a very big fan of you. And when you run so fast, it's like something is moving so fast. And how are everybody? And Usain Bolt, I'm in the hospital, and I'm very ill. So can you put up prayers for me, please? Bye.
Her parents, Rashida and Jermaine Bailey, who had struggled with her during her fight, they were featured in many of the tributes which eventually poured former Prime Minister, Most Honourable Portia Simpson Miller, in paying tribute to Bailey, wrote on Facebook, and I quote, although I already shared my Sunday inspiration message, I had to say thanks to little Geraldine. Her journey touched many of us. She was such a beam of light and joy. Geraldine inspired many of us. And again, Sim went to see her. Tough, 8 years old. And condolences to her family, her parents, obviously. Wonderful young lady.
Since we don't have the picture.
Did you not?
It's actually, no. I gave it, I sent it to them. I don't know if they have it. Very strong. I mean, she was a prayer warrior. So to have seen her like that a while ago shows you that she was really getting weak, but she had been fighting for a while. I just want to send prayers to her mom, who I spoke with at length, and her dad. It was a tough road for them, but at least now she's pain-free and she's at peace. So I guess that we give thanks for, but she will be missed. She will be missed. Okay, this is my Jamaica, right? Been a lot of crying going on around here,
all right, let's move on.
Okay.
So we had this scandal bag discussion that they want to, some people say ban it, they want to reduce scandal bag use in Jamaica. And apparently they said in Jamaica as of 2015, each person has been using almost 500 scandal bags per year.
Wow. An estimated, each person?
Yep, that's what they say, 500 scandal bags annually, and an estimated 75% increase from 2011. And it says, with those bags posing a significant threat to the environment and our health, Capri, the Caribbean Policy Research, they completed a study undertaken in partnership with the European Union. We sought to determine a best approach to reducing the presence of single-use plastic bags in Jamaica's waste stream. And they said, examining the cases of a range of countries, the most widely used and effective measures were found to be bans and fees. So there you go.
So that's something that we can take away as a learning.
Yep.
All right. moving on, back home, we have some folks who are blind complaining that motorists have been, well, generally become more indisciplined over the years. That's no secret. But they're using their canes now, and the cars not really paying very much attention to the folks who are crossing the road with the canes. So there's one young lady by the name of Camille Wilson who is saying that the cars aren't stopping anymore. We have to be begging persons to cross us. We can hardly cross independently anymore because the drivers are not considering the canes anymore. Now, if you think of what goes on never on the streets when you are driving as a sighted person, can you imagine trying to navigate crossing the street on the way for when the wheels of motor vehicles stop and the engines sputter before they make any effort to cross? Increasingly, they cannot help but hear the insults being hurled at those motorists who actually decide to stop and let them pass. I mean, I don't know.
You know, I am scared. I'm scared of the crowd.
Because you don't know who's going to come behind you.
But that's my point. That's my point. That happened to us. We were going to in Mandeville many, many years ago. And someone stopped to allow two kids. And they are across the road. And someone goes around them. And they were killed.
Oh, my God.
So sometimes I see youngsters, if there's no one behind me, then fine. But if the cars are coming, I'm scared to stop, even though sometimes I know I should. Because you don't want them to come. And then when you stop, the kids just run across. You know, they decide, say, well, all right, I can't go. So they just run across. So
it also happens with drivers, too. Like the other day, somebody stopped to let me out of a side road.
Yep.
And by the time I pulled out, there was a car
coming around. Yeah,
him.
Because them don't know why you stop. And
no
besides,
patience.
Them can't but
no
I stop.
Patience.
So sometimes I'm scared to let them across, even though, as I said, I know I should, because you don't want to put them in harm's way. All right, boy, we're just indisciplined, period.
It's argument, bad though, you know.
It's terrible.
It's the worst I've
terrible,
ever seen
man.
It. And
terrible,
I've been driving for
terrible.
A long time.
You even at that traffic light and you are turning right, and there's a man beside you, turn right at him, gone too. Can't wait till you go around. Him just come beside you and gone about in business. Israel begins telling African migrants to leave.
Wow.
They began warning thousands of African migrants Sunday that they must leave by the end of March on a plan that could see them jailed if they don't. So Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, he announced implementation of a plan to deport 38,000 migrants who had entered the country illegally. This is mainly Eritreans and Sudanese.
Mm.
So, wow.
Mm. Ben is Trump's friend, no?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
They call him something B. They call him BB.
BB. Netanyahu. Wow. 15,000 people subject to near-term deportation.
You know,
authorities offering those who agree to leave a grant of $3,500 a flight ticket and help with obtaining travel documents.
I was just going to say, I guess if you're in a country illegally, I suspect the country has the right to ask you to leave because you're there illegally.
It depends on how you got there, though, because the DACA kids are not there.
I was going to say that. There can be some kind of concession, I guess is the word I want. But I don't know. Anyway,
time for
some birthdays.
Yes.
Londa did not forget our sister's birthday this time. This is Sandy K. Blair. Sandy K., your sister Londa says she loves you. She hopes that you have an absolutely brilliant day today. It's also coming from your mom and dad, the rest of the family. And from your sister, Londa, happy birthday to Sergeant Wendell Reed. And Sergeant Reed's coming from your wife, Doreen, your sons, Wendell Jr., and your son, Ramon. I have two more pictures to show you.
Okay, let's go.
This one
so
is such a cutie. Her name is Cameron Chinyi. Her birthday is tomorrow. She's 4 years old tomorrow. From your mom, Stacy, your dad, Francis, and your sister, Anissa, and the rest of the family.
Adorable.
And, yep, and then I have one more to show you. This is Safari. Safari goes to St. George's College. She's in sixth form. Here's Safari right there. And Safari, happy birthday tomorrow.
Oh, she's a beautiful
girl. Yeah, she's beautiful. She's 19 tomorrow. And greetings coming from your mom, Carl, your brother, Sean. Your friends could have some different kind of names. So your friends, Nika Fry. Mansion, Thames Babe, Krish Galore, and Shemdon.
That's not their real names, that's their crew name.
I hope so. I hope it's not their real name.
Oh, God.
Yeah, that's it. You got none?
No.
All right, so happy birthday, folks. Have a brilliant day today and tomorrow, and many happy returns.
We know the key to unity of all people is in the dream that you had so long ago.